Fisher Z-Matic amplifier. It has two EL34s. Two GZ34s over here. And I'm not even sure what these are over here, but there's your preamp stages and a big resistor. Possibly the coolest thing about this amp is the capacitor covers that come off. Notice how that capacitor's a little bit shorter than this one? Well, to keep the top from falling in, they stuck a piece of newspaper inside there. I don't know if you can read that or not, but you see that date in the right corner? It says 1957. So there's a 1957 newspaper that was stuck in that. That ought to have something to do with the date. This thing has lots of power. Got this thing hooked to a University 312 25 watt speaker, coaxial speaker. Hopefully you can see it in there. Well, let's watch the power meter while we crank it up. There's nothing like the smell of an old, nice tube amp. Ah. If you know what I'm talking about, you know that smell. Perfect time of year to warm by it, too. Got a knob for constant voltage, constant power, and constant current. It has a click stop on constant voltage. So we're going to start with it there. Definitely has an interesting effect on the sound. I personally like it in the solid click of constant voltage, but constant power is not bad. If you go all the way over to constant current, the bass starts to distort a little bit, but yet at lower volumes the bass is more pronounced and so is the treble. It's almost like a loudness switch, a variable loudness switch. Kind of a neat control. And so here's the underside of my Z-Matic amp. is the companion to the Fisher, the FM tuner. A little staticky volume. There's Gulf 104. Tube amp this old with original capacitors, this thing is awfully quiet with no input. The camera I'm using to record this is louder than the little bit of slight bit of hum and a high pitch kind of swirly sound. Very, very low in the background is all that this thing is spitting out. And that's with all original capacitors.